So basically, friends, our topic is Coats disease. Now, as you can see in this picture, can you see here, there are exudates around the blood vessels. So the most important and the characteristic feature of Coats disease is exudates around the blood vessels. Also, if you can see here, these exudates are more in the temporal side. You can see an exudate here inferiorly also, but this exudate starts from the temporal side. If we can do a more clear picture of the fundus, we would see more of telangiectasia. That means the new vessels that are forming in the temporal side of the retina. So it is a type of telangiectasia where there are yellowish exudates all around the blood vessels, which starts more from the temporal side. Remember, it is a differential diagnosis of leukocoria. Other important differential diagnosis of leukocoria is retinoblastoma. But in Coats disease, it normally occurs in around 8 to 10 years of child, and there is a male dominance. But in retinoblastoma, it is more in the 2 to 5 years and there is no sex predilection. Also remember that in a case of retinoblastoma, you can see intraocular mass, but in a case of Coats disease, there are more blood vessel, more exudates around the blood vessels. Also, you have to remember that in Coats disease, in the later stage, you can get exudative retinal detachment. Okay.